Hello, and welcome to the OSHPD update for September 2019, where you can find out what's new and exciting here at the Office of Statewide Health Planning and Development. In August, OSHPD took part in the California Health and Human Services Agency's Data Expo in Sacramento. This event highlighted the pursuit of data-driven government and improving information sharing across agencies to better serve California's healthcare system. OSHPD staff spoke to an audience of more than 200 about its work with healthcare data. OSHPD published another quarter of data on new prescription drugs introduced to the market. This new data was released in August and provides users with an overview of new drugs on the market that have a wholesale acquisition cost of $670 or more for a course of treatment. Users can filter the drugs by date of release, manufacturer, drug product, or the wholesale acquisition cost. See the new quarter of data on our website or at the California Health and Human Services Agency's open data portal. In August, OSHPD covered the topic of severe sepsis in hospitals with its Data Pulse report series. In this report, OSHPD looks at the severe sepsis rates by hospital size and type. One of the key findings is small hospitals, those with less than 100 beds, have the highest rates of hospital-acquired severe sepsis. Read the Data Pulse on this topic and other subjects on the OSHPD website. OSHPD's work with healthcare data went nationwide in August as staff attended the National Academy for State Health Policy Conference in Chicago. OSHPD's Chief Data Officer, Starla Ledbetter, provided an update to a national audience on the implementation of the Prescription Drug Cost Transparency Law. In hospital construction news, the current environment of historically low interest rates is helping drive demand for OSHPD's CalMortgage Loan Insurance Program. In August, one of CalMortgage's repeat customers, the Los Angeles Jewish Home for the Aging, took advantage of the low rates and locked in a new $13.8 million loan at 3.1%. The new loan refinanced a prior CalMortgage deal used to construct a 108-unit senior living facility. The refinance saved the home more than $3.2 million in loan repayments. On the public meeting front, several boards and committees at OSHPD will be convening in September. The Hospital Building Safety Board's Education and Outreach Committee will host a meeting on September 11th, and the Healthcare Payments Data Review Committee will convene on September 19th. Also meeting in September will be the Hospital Building Safety Board's Structural and Non-Structural Regulations Committee on September 24th. For agendas, times, locations, and more, check out our public meetings page on our website. OSHPD has a lot going on and more coming up, so keep up to date by subscribing to our YouTube channel. For links to the web pages mentioned in this video, please see the video description section on our YouTube page. Thank you for watching.